So welcome to our application videos with our today's topic, FT-IR spectroelectrochemistry. FT-IR spectroelectrochemistry brings together both worlds, IR spectroscopy, giving important information about changes in chemical bonds in molecules, and electrochemistry, giving insights into oxidation or reduction processes and properties. This combined method is a very useful tool in the field of battery research or electrochemical conversion and allows to offer solutions in a world where fossil energy resources contribute to the climate crisis. In general, spectroelectrochemistry is a combination of a spectroscopic technique with an electrochemical method. FT-IR spectroelectrochemistry is very versatile for in situ observations of molecular vibrations during the alteration of an applied electrical potential. With its use, important information on the reaction mechanism can be derived. There are different possible measurement setups which can be applied: attenuated total reflection or external reflection. In this video, we will focus on the ATR technique for the measurement of the electrolyte solution. At Bruker, we offer for the Vertex and INVENIO FT-IR spectrometer series a reflection unit for electrochemical experiments. There's one version for the vacuum system and one version for the purged systems. An electrochemical cell can be simply inserted into this reflection unit. Then the beam is guided via mirrors at 30 or 60 degrees of incidence to a crystal window plate. This crystal window plate can be exchanged easily, realizing different measurement modes. Additionally, the use of polarized IR light is possible. Performing experiments on a vacuum FT-IR spectrometer gives you big advantages, because the complete beam path will stay under vacuum conditions and no ambient atmosphere will interfere with the IR light. This means the resulting spectra will be free from disturbance of atmospheric carbon dioxide or water vapor. You can see that here depicted in the spectrum. This is especially important for organic oxidation reactions where carbon dioxide is a reaction product. Now we will have a look at the A530 reflection unit in the lab and how it is prepared for an experiment. The A530 reflection unit can be easily installed into the INVENIO FT-IR spectrometer. Therefore, the standard cover is removed from it, and the standard transmission accessory is released with the quick lock button and also removed. Now the A530 can be inserted into the quick lock holder. Afterwards, the mirror pair with 30 degrees of incidence is installed and the mirrors are magnetically held in position. In this general overview, you can see all components which are needed for the electrochemical experiment, grouped together with the reflection unit. In the following, we will have a look how the parts are mounted together and installed into the system. For this reaction, we use the silicon ATR crystal plate, and a glass cell body is attached to it. Between the crystal and the glass cell, a carrot seal is placed to seal the cell tightly. There are different glass body shapes available, and they can be customized to the specific needs of the experiment. The glass body is fixed with 6 screws and a clamp ring. The screws should be fastened in an oppositely order and in a hand-tight way to avoid any damage to the glass body. Finally, the crystal window plate is installed into the aluminum tube for insertion into the reflection unit. Care has to be taken that the beam openings in the bottom plate are oriented in the same direction as the beam path. The electrochemical cell insert is fixed with 3 screws at the top. In addition, there are 3 further alignment screws on top which can be used to control the height of the complete electrochemical cell insert. It is possible to adjust the mirror by plus minus 5 degrees to realize different angles of incidence and to improve the optical alignment. The alignment and signal intensity can be controlled live in Opus in the Check Signal tab. Here you can see how the signal channel intensity increases. At the right side of the reflection unit, there's an additional slot which allows for insertion of additional polarizers or filters. Finally, the sample compartment cover of the reflection unit can be installed. This allows access to the electrochemical cell from the top during the reaction. The reaction which we'll present today is the oxidation of ferrocyanide, a molecular complex. After oxidation, the iron center of the complex changes its oxidation state, resulting in differences in the bonding strength of the cyanide ligands. This is directly apparent with time-resolved FT-IR spectroscopy, which is performed during the increase of the potential. A typical electrochemical cell is shown here of the slide in the center, and it is installed with a working reference and counter electrode and a supply for an inert gas line. The reaction will be observed with 8-unit total reflection. In this measurement mode, all electrodes are simply inserted into the electrochemical cell, and the working electrode will be positioned in proximity to the crystal surface of the crystal window. Alternatively, the crystal surface can be coated with a thin metal layer, so directly on the crystal window surface. And this metal layer acts as working electrode. This method has the advantages of surface enhancement effects and is known as ATR CIRAS. It will be discussed in detail in a future application video. Finally, also an IR transmitting crystal window can be used, and a reflective working electrode is placed in tight contact to the crystal window surface. This realizes a thin electrolyte layer, which is passed twice upon reflection of the IR beam on the working electrode surface. The FT-IR spectra are acquired over the course of an electrochemical method. Therefore, a gamma-ray potential start is used with chronoamperometry methods in which the potential is increased to 0.8 volt. Reversibility of the electrochemical reaction can be shown by going back to the original reference potential during FT-IR acquisition. Alternative electrochemical methods like cyclic voltammetry or linear sweep voltammetry runs can also be tracked with time-resolved spectroscopy. In the former, a voltage increase followed by the decrease is tracked, in the latter, the linear increase of the voltage. A synchronized start of the combined experiment is essential to produce reliable data. Therefore, the FT-IR spectrometer and the potentiostat can be synchronized with TTL trigger signals. This can be realized via the gamma-ray sequence wizard and the Opus time-resolved spectroscopy editor. Both systems are able to send and to receive trigger signals. The synchronization of newly created methods can be easily tested with a dummy cell, which is directly available with the potentiostat. So this dummy cell is shown here. So after this information overview, I want to show you the start and result of the IR spectrochemical experiment in the lab. The electrolyte solution containing the analyte is filled into the electrochemical cell. Afterwards, the set of electrodes is installed, containing of a gold working electrode, a platinum counter electrode, and a silver pseudo-reference electrode. In addition, a nitrogen purge line is connected to free the electrolyte solution from dissolved gases like oxygen. Therefore, the inert gas flows approximately 30 minutes through the solution before the start of the experiment. Now we can connect the electrodes with the gamma-ray potentiostat, and the potentiostat is switched on and establishes an USB connection. During the purging and waiting time, the methods can be set up in the software programs. On the left, you can see the Opus Time Resolved editor where an FT-IR run is prepared. The system waits for a trigger signal from the potentiostat and starts afterwards a loop of 400 spectra. This method is stored in an Opus TRS file. On the right side, you can see the Gamry sequence wizard. Here, an output trigger is generated followed by a linear sweep voltammetry run, increasing the voltage from 0 to 0.8 volt with a scan rate of 2 millivolt per second. At the end, the output trigger returns to its original value. As soon as the FT-IR method is started, it waits for the trigger signal coming from the potentiostat. And you can see how the FT-IR measurement proceeds as soon as the linear sweep voltammetry run is started. Finally, you can see how the FT-IR acquisition and the linear sweep voltammetry are running in parallel. Also, the other way around is possible. Therefore, a wait command is applied in the Gemry sequence wizard before a chronoamperometry run. In this run, the potential is stepped from 0 to 0.8 volt after a waiting time of 100 seconds. Now we can send a trigger signal from Opus, followed by the FT-IR measurement loop with 400 spectra. As soon as the Gamry sequence is started, the potentiostat waits for the trigger signal coming from the FT-IR spectrometer, and finally both systems start the data acquisition simultaneously. And again, you can see how the FT-IR acquisition and the chronoamperometry run are running in parallel. Let's jump to the end of the measurement and the created 3D data. The 3D FT-IR plot gives you the possibility to observe directly the emerged changes in the molecular bonds. It can be rotated freely to find a suitable view. The decrease in concentration of the ferrocyanide complex is visible at 2040 wave numbers, whereas the formation of the newly created ferrocyanide complex can be seen at 2115 wave numbers. On both scales, the wave number and the timescale indicator marks can be used to control the display in the spectra and traces view. We will select points of time at the beginning and at the end of this reaction. The corresponding spectra become directly visible in the spectrum display. Additionally, it is possible to select the individual spectra in the spectra list. Here a total of 1600 spectra are visible. This results from the use of the splitting option in the time-resolved spectroscopy editor to achieve a high temporal resolution below 1 second.
Thank you a lot for your interest and for watching our application video. And I hope to welcome you soon again with further interesting topics.